This question deals with molar absorptivity. It reads, a 4.13 times 10 to the minus 3 molar solution of a compound has an absorbance of 0.517 at 620 nanometers in a 1 centimeter cell. The solvent's absorbance under the same conditions is 0.013. And that should just read 0.013, not concentration unit. Okay. First question to answer is, what is the molar absorptivity of the compound? You may know Beer's law, which tells us that the absorbance is equal to E times L times C, where E is molar absorptivity, L is path length, and C is concentration. What you may not realize is that when you're really doing spectroscopy, sometimes the blank absorbs a little bit of light. So we're just going to add plus blank, the tiny amount that the blank absorbs, as a real-world adjustment to Beer's law. Okay, let's substitute our variables now. The absorbance is 0.517. E represents molar absorptivity. That's what we're trying to solve for. It's actually epsilon. The path length is 1 centimeter. The concentration that we're given is 4.13 times 10 to the minus 3 molar. And our blank is 0.013. Okay, we don't even use the 620 nanometers. That's just the wavelength that our measurements happen to be made under. The 620 really has no bearing on the math of solving this problem. All right, 0.517, we'll bring this value over, so minus 0.013, and we'll divide by 1 centimeter and also by 4.13 times 10 to the minus 3 molar. Punch that into our calculator, and the value that comes out is 122.0. 3 sig fix is good here, 122, and the units of molar absorptivity are centimeters to the minus 1, molar to the minus 1. So far, so good. The next question asks, what is the concentration if the absorbance of some unknown sample at the same wavelength and path length is 0.424? Okay, now notice something. This has to be proportional and linear, okay? So if 0.517 has 4.13 times 10 to the minus 3 molar, then 0.424 ought to be roughly about 4/5 of this concentration value. But we can just use the equation again. Okay, the absorbance, 0.424, is equal to epsilon, which is our molar absorptivity, and again, that's got units of centimeter to the minus 1, molar to the minus 1, times our path length, which is 1 centimeter, times our concentration, which is what we're going to solve for, plus the absorbance of the blank, 0.013. Okay, let's do our math. 0.424 minus 0.013 divided by 122 centimeters to the minus 1, molar to the minus 1, times 1 centimeter. Notice our centimeters are going to cancel out. Will be equal to our concentration. Okay, plug that into our calculator, and we get 3.360, basically. But again, 3 sig figs is good for this. 3.36 times 10 to the minus 3. And notice that 1 over molar just makes our units molar, which is perfectly good. So our answer is 3.36 times 10 to the minus 3 molar. Okay, that's all there is to that.